One of the best things about Suicide Squad is its rotating roster, because, you know, it keeps losing members, be it to missions or Waller's killer app. And speaking of Waller, I've decided to help her out and compile a dossier of potential candidates for the Suicide Squad sequel team. And I have two primary objectives: to add more meta power to the team, because again, that's how Waller pitched it, and I think that this team could use a little more juice. And also, I'd like to see more female members on the team. Now, I know there's already Katana, but Katana doesn't get a lot of screen time, and while she certainly has her fans, she doesn't have Harley Quinn level fandom. And I think there are some candidates here. I've found three, which I think could be as popular as Margot Robbie's Harley Quinn, if cast correctly and well realized. But the thing that I think Suicide Squad does best is realizing the characters. What they do with those characters, we're disagreeing on how on the quality of that, but still, hands down, we can all agree that Suicide Squad is great at makeovers, this team. But the other reason I want to see more women on the team is not only because of the popularity of Harley Quinn, but it's a smart business decision from Warner Brothers. And that's because, surprise, surprise, the Friday audience, at least for the movie, which is powering it to the biggest opening weekend ever for August, beating out Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy, is women, young women in particular. 46% of the Friday audience is female, and 28% under the age of 18. And not only did they show up, but they love the movie, giving it an A- or A cinema score, respectively, whereas the overall cinema score for the movie is a B+. So Warner Brothers, if they want to keep this fandom going and also inspire legions of cosplay, they need to add some more female members. So, and also, by the way, everybody I'm suggesting has been a Suicide Squad member in the comics. So the legit reasons are there as well. So first off, and everybody's saying they want this, Poison Ivy, who actually was a member of the Suicide Squad during its original run. Waller, pointed out how it would be in her best interests to work with the team. But Poison Ivy is fantastic because not only does she bring more power to the team, I think we would like to see, you could do like a more realistic version of Poison Ivy, but the Suicide Squad, that's not its hallmark, realism. So you want like the full-on plant-controlling poisons, poison-wielding Poison Ivy. But forget Deadshot, right? The original Harley Joker love triangle is with Poison Ivy, as imagined by the people that created Harley Quinn, Paul Dini and Bruce Timm. Now, what's also interesting about this is that Poison Ivy hates the Joker, and because of her power set and just who she is, she's one of the few people who isn't afraid to totally stand up to Mr. J. Not only, in defense of Harley, but because she just, hates him. But the only thing that would give me a concern about that is that, I think that there is some problem with emasculating Jared Leto's Joker in the Suicide Squad film, making Harley the crazier of the two. But anyway, Poison Ivy, I think, would be fantastic. It would not only, again, add power to the team, but she would add the chance for some character development and to see different sides of the two favorite characters in the first film, Harley Quinn and the Joker. Next up, Killer Frost, who was the other female member of the team in the animated movie Assault on Arkham, which was partially responsible for getting the Suicide Squad movie made. So Killer Frost would be a good addition in that regard. There's already, fan interest in her being on the team because of the love for that animated movie. She's also very powerful. She's basically the female Mr. Freeze, although instead of a freeze gun, it's her power set. And also, I have to say, it's a great visual power set. It could look really beautiful on film. And in fact, to date, interestingly enough, the best display of Mr. Freeze-type powers, I think, has been on Gotham Season 2. Just not only beautiful, but so dark and macabre, and the kills that Victor Freeze was able to rack up. So I think that would be fantastic. And then the third female candidate for the team is Plastique. Because, hey, explosions, as Michael Bay has proven, audiences love them. And he has been rewarded for his love of explosions with billions of dollars at the box office. So let's get some more explosions in Suicide Squad, courtesy of a new member. And we can have lots of shots in the film of the team slowly walking away from her handiwork. Now, also, this is a nice nod to the Justice League Unlimited animated series, where, as you might recall, in the episode where the Suicide Squad showed up, it was Deadshot, Boomerang, the two of the founding members of the team, and because that's why one of the reasons I think Boomerang is in the first Suicide Squad movie, just because, paying homage to the classic lineup, and also they're the most included members on the team consistently throughout its run in the comics. But the third person they put on that Suicide Squad was Plastique. Now, in some versions, Plastique is simply a bomb expert, but in others, she also has a power set, and that's that she can charge objects with her fingertips, a little bit like Gambit, cause them to go boom. So those are the three female candidates for the team, Waller, and I'm curious to see how you would advise Waller as well, but I did find some guys. All right, so Deathstroke. So many of you want to see Deathstroke on this team, but you know who I don't think wants to see Deathstroke in Suicide Squad 2? Will Smith. I think that Deathstroke's a little bit too similar to Deadshot, and I just don't think that Smith is going to allow him to be potentially overshadowed by a character that's juiced, right? Deadshot might have amazing aim, but Deathstroke has a healing factor, and he's juiced across the board, a little bit like Captain America, plussed in every department. He would add some more action sequences to the movie, but I'm sure Will Smith says, just write them for me. Next up, I came up with someone who would be expendable, because someone's got to die the next round too, and that would be the Clock King. And the reason I picked him is because I thought that with his, his fascination and obsession, some would argue, with time, would allow him to help Waller planning missions. And not just plan the missions, but maybe create some more intricate missions that would be fun for us to watch. However, the more I thought of that, I thought, well, why not bring the Riddler in? There's a lot of interest in seeing the Riddler return to the big screen, in a way that's a little bit more loyal to the comics. It would be very interesting to see how this creative team would imagine him. And while he's never been on the Suicide Squad, neither was the Joker. Although technically he's not on the Suicide Squad here. But Riddler, I think, would do a fantastic job helping to plan missions. And he would bring that kind of star power, I think Poison Ivy being the other person, to the movie, making people really want to see it. Because there are those famous, iconic Batman villains. But then back to actual Suicide Squad members from the past. Cluemaster. Why? One word. Spoiler. Yes, Arthur Brown, this guy has no superpowers. He's kind of lame. But what he has gifted to the DC universe in the comics and in animation to some degree is Spoiler, aka Stephanie Brown. A female character in the Batman family, had a relationship with Tim Drake. They actually had one of the Robins. They actually had a child together. And she was a Robin for a time being. It didn't go so well. No one liked it. And DC, took care of it accordingly. But she's had a rough time, but she has a very strong fan base. And again, one of the strengths of Suicide Squad has been its appeal to fans. So to give a Stephanie Brown Easter egg in a Suicide Squad 2 movie would be fantastic. Maybe don't even put Cluemaster on the team. Just consider recruiting him or have him being in prison, maybe some of the other Suicide Squad members, and have him Stephanie come visit him or have him mention her or have a picture of her. Just something. Fans would go crazy. Then my final pick for the guys is King Faraday. Why? Well, he's basically DC's version of James Bond. He's a super spy, and he has not only the espionage abilities, but the fighting abilities that go along with that. But I want him to replace Rick Flagg. Why? Well, I'm not a big fan of Joel Kinnaman's Rick Flagg, but I just recently read the Suicide Squad Rebirth number one issue, and I was very impressed with how they position their version of Rick Flagg. Now, they can't do this in the movie because they've already set up Rick Flagg as a patsy, right? Who thinks with a different part of his body than his head. But I like that in the comic, they pitched Rick Flagg as the moral compass for the Suicide Squad, that Amanda Waller is so devoid of morality, which allows her to do her job, to be fair, that in the comic, President Obama said, okay, let's get Rick Flagg on this team to lead it, to be the team's Jiminy Cricket, so to speak, right? It's conscience. Let your conscience be your guide. So I would love to see King Faraday come in and you know, be that, you know, that yin to Waller's yang. I think that would be really good. And I was very impressed with the, what they created in the DC Rebirth comic in terms of that dynamic. Or Immortal Steve Trevor, which I'm still pulling for unless I see him die in the Wonder Woman movie. I really want to see Chris Pine stick around. I like the idea of Steve Trevor, you know, being more than just Wonder Woman's boyfriend. And I think having him, you know, going underground to be a part of the Suicide Squad to balance out Viola Davis's Amanda Waller would be pretty awesome. Now, the last thing I want to address is that some of you are going to be like, Grace, why isn't Black Manta one of your picks? Or Cheetah, previous members of the Suicide Squad, and, you know, Aquaman and Wonder Woman villains. Well, let me just explain very quickly. And you can counter down below in the comments. As for Black Manta, he's really an underwater villain, and I don't really want to see any underwater missions. You know, they're hard to film, especially in live action. And I think that Killer Croc showed that there isn't, I mean, this team, you know, they're not as cool when wet. Although I guess Harley Quinn gets a lot of mileage out of being wet for some fans, but you know, then it can just rain. We don't need Black Manta for it to rain. So I wouldn't have Black Manta. I mean, he's a cool strategic character, but again, he's just gonna take away from Will Smith's Deadshot. Then as for Cheetah, we just have too many speedsters right now. We have competing Quicksilvers as it is, and we just had someone who's possessed by a god, Enchantress. So I wouldn't want a redo of that so soon. So those are my picks for the Suicide Squad sequel, for the roster. Who would you advise Waller recruit? And you can check out some more episodes right now.